गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिनी व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। यो ब्रह्माण्ड विजाति पूर्वं यदागश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तदुम्ह देवमात्मोद्य प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ओम शांति शांति शांति। आम्ना यान्तिक संसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। We looked at the second Varnaka of the earlier Adhikarana. Now the next Adhikarana, Karyakhyana Adhikarana, begins with an introduction in the Vrittiyas. Purvatra Sandigda Sadupakramasya Vakyasheshat Niranayavatu Achamanti Iti Vartamana Apadeshasya Vidittu Sandehe Achamet Iti Vakyasheshat Vidittu Niranayaha इति दृष्टांत संगत्या इदमाह। सो देयर इज अ दृष्टांत संगति एज टू व्हाट कंपेयर टू व्हाट वाज डन अर्लियर अ सिमिलर थिंग रादर व्हाट वाज डन अर्लियर अ सिमिलर थिंग कैन बी सीन एल्सवेयर सेज द पूर्व पक्षी। सो ही सेज दिस उपक्रम इन छांदोग्य षष्ठो अध्याय सदैव सौम्य इदमग्र आसीत् देयर सच्छब्द was seen as Brahma. Why? Because in Upasamhara also there was Atma Shabda, and that Atma Shabda Saha Atma, it was said with a pronoun Saha, Sarvanama Saha, that which was in the Upakrama is the very same thing, that is Atma, Saha Atma, and then Tattvamasi Shweta Ketu Ityadi. So the sad in the upakrama, in the opening, is that word pada sad pada means Brahma for Brahmatma, for the Siddhanti, for the Purvapakshi. He said it was doubtful as to what that sat means. Sat is literally whatever it means, but it is not Brahma, it is not Atma. This was what we had seen as an objection in the earlier Adhikarana, and it was resolved. The Sandigda Sad Upakramasya. Sandigda is in case of which there is a doubt. So there was a doubt, Sandeha was there. So Sandigda Sad Upakramasya Vakya Sheshat. Vakya Sheshat is Sahatma. And thereby that Saha has to mean Sat itself, Sad Brahma, and Sad Brahma is Atma. And Sat has to mean Brahma because Utpatti is from that Sat. So we saw all that. Now, similarly, Niranayavat, how Niranaya was taken, how a decision as to what is the Tatparya of Satshabda was also taken in the Chandogya Upanishad, as covered in the earlier one Varnaka, one interpretation of the earlier Adhikarana. So, similarly, Niranayavat, similarly is what? Achamanti iti Vartamana Apadeshasya. So Vartamana Apadesha, Apadesha is a Prayoga. So Vartamana Latlakara Prayoga is there, Vartamane Lat. So Latlakara Achamanti Prayoga is there. Such word is heard in one Shruti, in Brihadaranyaka 6th chapter I think. Then this Latlakara is in Vartamana Kala, meaning Achamanti means they do Achamana. They do Achamana, that's all it means. So it's a, they do or they are doing Achamana, this is the meaning of Latlakara Vartamana Kala, there is no Vidhi there. So Vidhitva Sandehe, when there is a Sandeha regard to Vidhi in Latlakara, it is not Vidhiling, it is not Lotlakara, there is no Tavya, Aniya Rityadi Pratya. Therefore, it is just an Anuvada of Dvija is doing Achamana. So after Bhojana, for example, आचमन इज डन. बिफोर भोजमन ऑल्सो बिफोर ईटिंग समथिंग आचमन इज डन. सो वॉट इज बींग सेड इज दैट देर इज नो विधिलिंग देर. इट इज नॉट अ विधि. इट इज जस्ट अ स्टेटमेंट इन दि वर्तमान काल दैट द्विजाज डू आचमन. दे सिप वॉटर. दैट्स ऑल इट मीन्स. एंड देर फोर देर इज नो विधि. वेर एज इट इज ऑकरिंग इन दि वेदास. वेद वेदांत इज श्रुति. एंड बींग श्रुति एवरीथिंग देर हैज टू बी ए विधि. इट के नॉट जस्ट बी एन यू नो सिंपल लट्लकार इन वर्तमान काल दैट समबडी डज आचमन बिफोर भोजन आफ्टर भोजन. इट के नॉट बी जस्ट अ स्टेटमेंट इन वर्तमान काल. इट हैज टू बी ए विधि एज पर पूर्वमीमांसक. पूर्वमीमांसक सेज दैट एवरी लकार इज एक्चुअली लेट लकार एंड लेट लकार इज इन द मीनिंग ऑफ विधि. दिस इज हाउ द पूर्वमीमांसा वुड यूजुअली से. बट नाउ इफ यू आर डूइंग स्पेसिफिक एनालिसिस आचामंती दे डू आचमन देन विधित्व संदेह इज देर. देर इज डाउट रिगार्डिंग वेदर इट इज अ विधि और नॉट अ विधि. इज इट एन अनुवाद. इज इट अ विधि. वॉट इज इट. इज इट एन अर्थवाद. वी डू नॉट नो वॉट इट इज सेज द पूर्व पक्षी. देन वॉट डज ही से यू हैव टू डू द सेम एनालिसिस द वे यू द सिद्धांति हैज डन. वील ऑल्सो डू द सेम एनालिसिस एंड आचामेत इति वाक्यशेष. देर इज अ वाक्यशेष आचामेत एंड दैट इज अ विधिलिंग. सो फर्दर आफ्टर यू सी आचामंती इन दी सेम सेक्शन यू सी आचामेत मीनिंग वन शुड डू आचामन. आचमन वन शुड सिप वॉटर ड्यूरिंग भोजन मीनिंग आफ्टर भोजन एंड बिफोर भोजन वन शुड डू आचमन. नाउ दिस इज मेन्शंड रिगार्डिंग भोजन. ड्यूरिंग भोजन काल हाउ शुड बी द व्यवहार ऑफ द द्विज. इज दैट वॉट द श्रुति इज सेइंग. वन सेकेंड इज इट अ विधि दैट यू शुड डू इट इन दिस मैनर एज टू द रीजन फॉर आचमन इज प्राण इज नग्न एंड यू हैव टू कवर हिम अप. कवर द प्राण बिकॉज वेन यू eat food it is considered as ahuti pranahuti. Vaishvanara agni is there in the jathara and then when dvijas eat food what do they do during bhojana kala? They sip water and also what they do prana agni hotra. Pranayasva apanayasva vyanayasva udanayasva samanayasva ityadi brahmaneswaha. So this panchaprana ahuti is given and before giving ahuti to prana and the entire bhojana is basically yajna. And since there is no real agni, meaning there is no physical agni the way it is there in yaga, this agni is in the jathara. Therefore it is an upasana. It's an upasana. It is a yaga. Yaga kind of an upasana. And what is the purpose of sipping the water in that upasana? The sipping the water, one has to do chintana that prana is being covered. This water, when you sip water, you are offering clothes. You are offering clothes to prana devata. And prana, who is otherwise nagna, is now made anagna. He is clothed. It is an offering of clothes. So now this chintana has to be done. Now the Purvapakshi has said that Achamet is a vidhi, therefore, that you have to do Achamana in that Pranagni Hotra Upasana. Iti Vakyasheshat Vidhitva Niranaya Iti Drishtanta Sangatya Idama. Now this has become a vidhi. So when you look at Achamanti, that is also a vidhi. Why? Because Vakyashesha says Achamet and both put together it will become a vidhi as to one has to sip water. In this prana agnihotra kind of upasana. And thereby karyakhyana adhikarana comes up where Bhagavan Sutrakara says karyakhyanad apurvam. Karyakhyanad apurvam. So karyakhyanad apurvam. That is a padachheda. Karyasya akhyanat. Akhyana is kathana. So due to kathana, kathanat, kasya kathanat. कथनात् कार्यस्य विच कार्य दिस कार्य विच इज आचमन सिद्धांति सिंह आचमन इज अ कार्य इट इज अ क्रिया वन हैज टू सिप वॉटर एंड दिस इज प्रसिद्ध दैट अ द्विजा हैज टू सिप वॉटर कीप सिपिंग वॉटर ऑल द टाइम फॉर शुद्धि सो यू सी यू नो इफ यू सीन ओल्ड ईरा ब्राह्मणस और द्विजास दे वुड बी सिपिंग वॉटर वेर एवर यू गो यू सी यू नो मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स वॉट एवर हैपन्स दिल सिप वॉटर फॉर शुद्धि समथिंग गोज रॉन्ग सिप वॉटर सो इट इज फॉर शुद्धि नाउ दिस इज नोन फ्रॉम स्मृति ऑल्सो फ्रॉम व्यवहार फ्रॉम द व्यवहार ऑफ द अर्लियर जनरेशन द्विजास वी सी वॉटर इज बींग सिप्ड सो स्मृति प्रमाण इज ऑल्सो देर वेर यू सी यू डोंट नीड अ श्रुति टू टेल यू दैट बिकॉज स्मृति प्रमाण इज देर एंड व्यवहार इट इज प्रसिद्ध दैट द्विजास सिप वॉटर फॉर शुद्धि नाउ विदाउट शुद्धि यू कैनॉट डू भोजन बिकॉज भोजन इज अ यागा इज कल्चरली नोन द्विजास नो दैट भोजन इज बेसिकली याग जस्ट लाइक इन याग यू डू नॉट मिक्स अप अशुद्ध और somebody who has not had a bath etc is not mixed up somebody who is not in you know proper clothes which is appropriate for the yaga that person is not supposed to enter the yagashala so a person who belongs to a particular varna who has adhikara in that yaga who has had shuddhi meaning bath and has basically worn clean clothes that person is allowed to be in the yagashala similarly when a person is doing bhojana it is a yaga so it is not you are mixing food with others and eating so people say you know socially you know what is the harm in eating with everyone so there is a huge noise these days we see it is all a modern era thing who do not have absolutely any clue of what is a yaga let alone bhojana being a yaga so dvija is supposed to do bhojana and actually that is the reason that people do not talk I mean those who are very orthodox they do not talk during bhojana because it is a yaga and since it is not a real yaga in the sense physically there is no agni there is a chintana to be done and it is subtler than the outer yaga therefore one has to have a focused mind while eating therefore one should not be talking let alone mix with others and eat with anyone and everyone eating with anyone and everyone is not to be done for this reason it is not that you know people say that you know these people are castes they keep everyone aside actually even the person belonging to the same caste who has not worn appropriate clothing who has not had a bath or is you know is sweating etc who is unclean should not be eating together with a person who is doing it as a yaga anyway so that's an aside on a related note so karyasya prasiddhasya karyasya this karya achamanasya akhyanat kathanat prasiddha achamana karyasya akhyanat kathanat apurvam So what is Siddhanti saying? Siddhanti says, look at this Achamana being mentioned in the Shruti, Achamanti. So Achamanti, even if you take Achamet as a Vidhi, what will happen is that it is already known activity. Achamana is a known activity. Now Achamana being a known activity, it is Prasiddha, known meaning well known, not just known by you know someone who is a pandita but it is well known in the vaidika society that achamana is for shuddhi well known in the smriti granthas also therefore what is revealed by the shruti here is not the achamana but the upasana related to this prana in bhojana and now if you take both as what both as meaning the prana upasana of this yaga kind of an upasana एंड दिस आचमन बोथ एज ए विधि देन देर बी वाक्य भेद. सिंगल वाक्य कैनॉट बी गिविंग टू विधिज, इट कैन गिव ओनली वन विधि. सो इफ यू से दैट आचमन इज अ विधि देन इट कैनॉट बी उपासना सेज सिद्धांति. इफ इट इज उपासना विच इज अ विधि देन आचमना कैनॉट बी द विधि. एंड हियर इट मेक्स सेंस दैट आचमना इज प्रसिद्ध देयर फॉर इट इज नॉट अ विधि, इट इज जस्ट एन अनुवाद. सो वॉट इज इट कथना, सिंस प्रसिद्ध से कथना अपूर्व, अपूर्व मीन्स अपूर्व विधानार्थ. जनरली वॉट इज सेड इज दैट सो इन मीमांसा वॉट इज सेड इफ इट इज वेल नोन देन इट इज अपूर्व. सो अपूर्व विधानार्थम इट इज बेसिकली अनुवाद ऑल्सो वन कैन सी इन दैट मैनर. एंड पूर्व पक्षी कैन ऑल्सो बी सेइंग दैट इट इज अ विधि, इट इज एन अपूर्व विधि. सो इट कैन बी सीन फ्रॉम द पूर्वपक्षी दृष्टि ऑल्सो. सो सम टेक दिस एज अ पूर्व फ्रॉम द पूर्वपक्षी दृष्टि दृष्टांत संगत्य, लुक एट दिस इज एन अपूर्व विधि. फ्रॉम द सिद्धांतिस पर्सपेक्टिव इट कैनॉट बी विधि बिकॉज देर बी वाक्य भेद, वाक्य भेद इज कंसिडर्ड एज अ दोष. एंड देयर बाय बोथ वेज इट कैन बी सीन, द सूत्र कैन बी सीन फ्रॉम बोथ एंगल्स. अत्र पूर्वं प्राणविद्यांगत्वेन अपूर्वस्य आचमनस्य विधेयत्वात् तस्य अन्यत्र प्राणविद्यायाम् उपसंहारः, सिद्धांते तु अनुपसंहार इति फलभेद. सो मोस्टली इट कैन बी सीन एज अ, बिकॉज अपूर्व विधि हैज बीन गिवन, इट इज नॉट सीन एज अ एज बेसिकली अनुवाद एंड नॉट अ विधि, देन इट कैन बी सीन एज अ पूर्वपक्षी सूत्र. सो पूर्वपक्ष इज सेइंग व्हाट, पूर्वपक्ष इज सेइंग पूर्वं प्राणविद्या अंगत्वेन, अत्र प्राणविद्या इज प्राण उपासना. सो एज एन अंग, एज अ सब्सिडरी और अ सैटेलाइट कर्म, नॉट कर्म, सैटेलाइट पार्ट, अ पार्ट ऑफ अंग ऑफ प्राणविद्या प्राण उपासना, वॉट वॉज अपूर्वस्य आचमनस्य, पूर्व मीनिंग दिस आचामंती, दैट हैज बीन सेड. सो प्राणविद्या अंगत्वेन अपूर्वस्य आचमनस्य विधेयत्वात् इट इज अ विधि, तस्य अन्यत्र प्राणविद्यायाम् उपसंहार. देयरफॉर व्हाट शुड वन डू एल्सवेयर वेरेवर देयर इज अ प्राणविद्या प्राण उपासना, देयर दिस आचमना शुड बी ब्रॉट इन. और एवरी गुण, एवरीथिंग दैट इज डिस्कस इन दी प्राणविद्या हियर शुड बी क्लब टुगेदर विद दी प्राणविद्या एल्सवेयर इन अदर शाखास और इवन इन द सेम शाखा. सो प्राण इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ प्राणविद्या, आचमना इज एन अंगा टू प्राणविद्या. सो वेर एवर देर इज प्राणविद्या उपासना, आचमना शुड बी ब्रॉट टुगेदर. बट वॉट इज द केस इफ वन इज डूइंग उपासना एल्सवेयर इन प्राणविद्या, वॉट एवर इट इज यू नो वॉट एवर गुणाज आर डिस्कस इन दैट सेक्शन, दोज गुणाज शुड बी अप्रोप्रिएटली अप्लाइड इन दैट प्राणविद्या. वाई वुड यू ब्रिंग आचमना ड्यूरिंग भोजना देर? This is what the Siddhanti is saying. Purvapakshi says, no, it is an anga to pranavidya, therefore achamana ityadi, all of this should be clubbed together in all pranavidyas. So pranavidya upasamhara, prana upasana will have all of this done during bhojana kala and vice versa. Siddhanti twin, Siddhanta however, Siddhanti is saying anupasamhara, you should not club together these upasanas iti phalabheda. This is the difference between Purvapakshi and Siddhanti. Brihadaranyaka बृहदारण्यक छांदोग्ययोः, बृहदारण्यक छांदोग्ययोः उभयत्र एवं विद एवं विद अशिष्यन् नाचमेत अशित्वा च आचमेत एतमेव तदनम तद अनम अनग्नम कुरुते इति श्रूयते. सो इन बृहदारण्यक एंड छांदोग्य उभयत्र इन बोथ प्लेसेस व्हाट इज हर्ड दिस एवं विद अशिष्यन् आचमेद, आचमेद इज हर्ड, आचमंती आचामंती हैज बीन हर्ड अर्लियर, नाउ आचमेद इज अ विधिलिंग. अशित्वा हैविंग ईटन, हैविंग ईटन हैविंग डन भोजना वन शुड डू आचमना. एंड आचमेद एतमेव तद अनम तद अनमग्नम अनग्नम, अनग्नम मीनिंग अनग्नम, वन हु इज नग्न प्राण, प्राण इज विदाउट क्लोज नग्न एंड अनग्नम कुरुते. दिस इट्सेल्फ, व्हाट इज दिस, दिस सिपिंग ऑफ द वाटर आचमना इट्सेल्फ वन शुड डू आचमना बिकॉज दिस कवर्स अ प्राण, इट इज ऑफरिंग क्लोज टू प्राण. प्राण इज ड्रेस्ड अप इति श्रूयते. दिस इज हर्ड इन बृहत एंड छांदोग्य एज वेल. तत्र आचमनम अनग्नता चिंतनं च प्रतीयते. सो व्हाट डू यू नो नाउ? आचमेद इज अ विधिलिंग एंड देन अनग्नं कुरुते. दी अन 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 इज अन. इफ यू ऐड प्र प्र पूर्वक अन विल कम प्राण प्राण एंड देयर विल बी नत्वम. सो तद अनम अनग्नं कुरुते मीन्स प्राणम अनग्नम कुरुते. दिस आचमन वन शुड डू आचमन वन एंड देन दिस इट्सेल्फ दैट आचमन इट्सेल्फ तद तद आचमनम व्हाट डज इट डू? अनम मीनिंग प्राणम अनग्नम कुरुते मेक्स इट क्लोथ मेक्स प्राण क्लोथ्ड. सो व्हाट डज इट मीन नाउ? दिस कुरुते इज ऑल्सो लट्लकार. लट्लकार इज ऑल्सो विधि हियर. तत्र आचमनम अनग्नता चिंतनं च प्रतीयते. सो व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड देयर? इट इज ऑफरिंग ऑफ क्लोथ्स मीनिंग यू शुड थिंक दैट यू आर ऑफरिंग क्लोथ्स. दैट चिंतन हैज टू बी डन. देयरफॉर अनग्नता चिंतन इज वन पार्ट एंड आचमन इज अनदर पार्ट. आचमन एंड अनग्न चिंतन बोथ वी अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम दिस वाक्य. तत्र उभय विधाने वाक्य भेद भयाद एकमेव विधेयम्. नाउ इफ बोथ आर ऑर्डेन्ड as to what one should do achamana, one second this achamana should be seen as clothing prana, second vidhi. Therefore there is vakya bheda. Single vakya cannot give two vidhis. Therefore ubhaya vidhane vakya bheda bhaya. There will be vakya bheda which is a dosha. So due to bhaya that one has to avoid this vakya bheda, we cannot take this. What should one do? Therefore ekameva vidhyam, only one is ordained, not both. So which one is ordained? Tad ekam kim achamanam uta anagnata chintanam iti samshaye. Whether it is a single vidhi has to be taken to avoid vakya bheda. Now which one is the vidhi? Now is it achamana which is given as a vidhi, or is it anagna chintana of prana as an upasana which is ordained? So achamanam iti purvapaksha. Purvapakshi says that it is the sipping of water achamana which is ordained. Siddhantastu, whereas in siddhanta what is it? Anagnata chintanam eva apurvam. So now the siddhanti interpretation, if you see the purvapakshi interpretation, he says the apurva vidhi can be seen, vidhi, it is a vidhi, but siddhanti, as per the Siddhanti, this sutra can be seen as Siddhanta sutra. In which manner? Siddhantastu anagnata chintanam eva apurvam. It is not the, which is a vidhi here, apurva vidhi is anagnata chintana, not the prasiddha karya. And thereby, apurvam prana vidya angatvena vidheyam. What is not known? What is not known? So, prasiddha karya is known. If you take the prasiddha karya itself as vidheya, then it is not apurva vidhi. It is not something which is not known. So prasiddhasya kathanam is being done. Only an anuvada of the earlier is being done, which is well known, and thereby aprasiddha, apurva, is being ordained. So now we know that this is a Siddhanta sutra. You can look at it because both ways it has been seen. One is karyakhyanad apurvam. Purvapakshi cannot justify this as to apurva vidhi. Why? Because prasiddha karyasya akhyanad. Purvapakshi, if you take it, then you have to say what karyasya akhyanad, meaning kathanad. But there prasiddha cannot be added because some kriya has been mentioned. Purvapakshi is saying because kriya has been mentioned. What is that kriya? Achamana. See, in Latlakar also kriya has been mentioned, and vidhi is karma rupa, kriya rupa, and since there is a kriya it has to be vidhi, says the Purvapakshi, thereby apurva vidhi can be seen. Siddhanti, if you look at Siddhanti's perspective in this, in that is the sutra, what do we see? Karya is prasiddha. Karyasya akhyanat kathanat is all right, which is that karya achamana. Achamanasya akhyanat. But what is this achamana? It is karma, therefore it has to be a vidhi, says the Purvapakshi. Siddhanti says it is a prasiddha karma. Everyone does it. It is already known. Then this is an anuvada matra. And if in that ausha, if there is anuvada, Then the in the other aprasiddha amsha as to prana being clothed, there it is a vidhi. So it is a apurva vidhi. So anagnata chintana is apurva, unknown, and therefore that is the vidhi as prana vidya anga. Prana vidya angatvena vidhyamna achamanam. Achamana is not the vidhi. Kutaha. Why do you say so? Karyakhyanat, which we have already seen. So dvijo nityam upaspraśet ityadina smartha vidina sakala anushthana angatvena shuddhyartham karyasya achamanasya pranavidyayamapi vidipraptasya akhyanat anagnata vidhanartham anuvadad ityarthaha. So what we already seen as to dvijaha nityam upaspraśet is a smriti ityadina smartha vidina. There is a smartha vidhi. In smriti grantha there is already a vidhi as to dvija should do achamana. For what purpose? Sakala anushthana angatvena shuddhyartham. As dvija who is doing all the nitya karma throughout the day, if dvija starts doing every nitya karma which is ordained, there will be absolutely no time for anything else. There is so much to do throughout the day. Other than rest and bhojana, there will hardly be any time left to do anything else on most days. So sakala anushthana angatvena, when he is doing anushthana of each and everything that is ordained, and of course, I mean, not only nitya, we are also saying the kamya karma also, you'll have to add some of the kamya karmas, can be done as, meaning they are ordained, they can be done as nitya also and kamya also. So you drop the kamya also, then also most of the days filled with nitya karma, and therefore anushthana, upasana ityadi are also being done. Karmanga upasanas, karma, karmanga upasanas, and then there are separate upasanas also. If one keeps on doing it, there will be nothing else that can be done because the time is already consumed. So shuddhyartham, for the purpose of shuddhi, as a part of each and every anushthana, sakala, sarva, sarva anushthana angatvena shuddhyartham, for this purpose of shuddhi, one has to do achamana, that is known through smriti grantha. Karyasya achamana, so therefore this karya which is achamana, known through smriti grantha, is prasiddha, and therefore pranavidyayam api vidipraptasya akhyanat. In pranavidya also, here in Brihad and Chandogya Shruti, also what do you see? Vidipraptasya. It is already known as a vidhi. We are not saying that it is not a vidhi, but in this Shruti it is not a vidhi. It is already known. Therefore, akhyana is just a kathana here, anuvada. Akhyanad anagnata vidhanartham anuvada dityarsa. So akhyanad means anuvadat. It is just a repetition. Why is it repeated? What is well known is repeated there. It is just saying that, oh, you do the achamana elsewhere also. This is also an anushthana. We are going to give you another vidhi, and this, it is anushteya vidhi, anushthana has to be done. Therefore, during this also you have to do achamana, which you already know. So, just a kathana is being given. Why? To say that there is another vidhi coming up. Which is that vidhi? Anagnata vidhi. So, anagnata vidhanartham, for the purpose of ordaining this anagnata of prana, which is a vidhi, an upasana given, this anuvada of achamana is just done. You will see, you know, if you are doing some karma, then across, you know, two karmas or something being done, then as a part of it, you already know achamana. So how to do achamana, all that is not mentioned. What does the purohita just say? He just say, just do achamana. Do one achamana, do two achamanas. Purohita will tell you, in the middle of other karmas that we are doing, so he'll say, you know, just do achamana now, and then again when to do achamana he'll tell you. So all that is what achamana that you already know. In the special karma which you do not know, there achamana is just mentioned that you have to do at this step. That's all. So anuvada, it is just an anuvada ityartha. पूर्वत्र सो दैट दैट इज अ सिंगल सूत्र अधिकरण वी हैव सीन द पूर्व पक्ष ऑल्सो एंड द सिद्धांत ऑल्सो इन द सेम सूत्र बोथ इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफकोर्स द इंटरप्रिटेशन फाइनली विल बी द सिद्धांत इज इंटरप्रिटेशन पूर्व पक्षी बिकॉज इति चेत एटसेट्रा इज नॉट देर सो सिंस इति चेत इत्यादि इज नॉट देर पूर्व पक्ष हैज टू बी सीन देयरफॉर वी सॉ द सूत्र फ्रॉम द पूर्व पक्षीज एंगल ऑल्सो एंड देन द रिफ्यूटेशन एज टू वॉट द सिद्धांत इज सेइंग विद द सेम सूत्र पूर्वत्र प्राप्त आच आचमन अनुवादाद सॉरी पूर्वत्र प्राप्त आचमन अनुवादेन अनग्नता चिंतनम विधेयम इत्युक्तम सो व्हाट इज पूर्वपक्षी सेइंग इन द अर्लियर अधिकरण यू सेड दैट देयर कैन बी ओनली वन विधि इन वाक्य अदरवाइज देयर विल बी वाक्य भेद देयरफॉर The Achamana Vidhi is Prapta Vidhi and Prapta Vidhi also. Whatever is Prapta, Prapta is only restated and therefore it is Anuvada. And through that Anuvada of one Vidhi, the other is considered as the real Vidhi. Thereby, Anagnata Chintana, that Upasana of Prana as being clothed by Achamana is a Vidhi, Vidheyam Iti Uktam, Ihatu. Here in this context, Purvapaksha will bring in the context of Brihad again. Yatu ekashakhayam viprakrishta pradeshastha vakyayoho ekasya anuvadakattvam anyasya vidhayakattvam iti anishchayad ubhayorapi swanikatastha guna vishishta vidya vidhayakattvam iti pratyudharana sangatya idamaha. Purvapakshi says that across different shrutis, prana vidyas are given. And in Brihat and Chandogya, see when I say Brihat and Chandogya Shakha, it is not, the Shakha's name is not Brihat or Chandogya. For simplicity in communication, I am saying this. There are two different Shakhas in which Brihat occurs. But then what I mean there is that Brihat Shakha, meaning where Brihat occurs, that Shakha, whether it is Rana and Ityadi, so Madhyandina or the other Shakha. So there are two different in Shukla Yajurveda also, this Brihadaranyaka where it occurs, there are two different pathas, there are two shakhas. So that wherever this Brihadaranyaka occurs, it occurs in both places. So where it occurs, there that is what we mean by Brihadaranyaka shakha, Chandogya Shaka Ityadi. So Katha is the name of the Shaka. So Katha Upanishad, that itself is the name of the Shaka also. Katha Shaka, Taittiriya Shaka. Or if you, in some parts of the South, the entire Krishna Yajurveda is considered as a Shaka. So they say Krishna Yajurveda Shaka. It can be Taittiriya also, it can be Katha also, or it can be both put together. So it is said as entire Shaka. Together is the entire Yajurveda itself, Krishna Yajurveda itself is considered as a single Shaka by many. Okay, anyway, that's an aside, just to say that I am using these words very loosely as to Brihat Shaka Ityadi, just to say Brihadaranyaka Upanishad occurs in that Shaka, that's all the intention is. It is not the accurate name of the Shaka. So with that buffer, Ihatu Eka Shakhayam Viprakrishta Pradeshastha Vakyayoho. Now the Purvapakshi is moving on to Brihad as an example, where in a single shakha, multiple karmas are there, multiple upasanas are also there. The Mimamsa has to be done as to whether the karmas mentioned across shakhas or within the same shakhas across sections is one and the same. Similarly, upasana also, you analyze. You did analyze upasanas across shakhas and you concluded as to many of these upasanas are to be clubbed together. You have to do upasamhara of the gunas discussed in various shakhas. And the very recent example was prana vidya, where guna upasamhara should not be done across shakhas. Why? Because you said that there is an anuvada of achamana that should not be taken across shrutis, across prana vidyas, across prana vidyas in various shakhas. Now what was the reason given? There anuvada was given, and then you said that one is an anuvada, achamana vidhi is an anuvada, whereas apurva is only the anagnata chintana, prana anagnata chintana, that is the vidhi. Ihatu, in this single shaka, ekashakayam, in this brihat shaka, in the same shaka, viprakrishta pradeshastha vakyayo, the vakyas which are separated by a great distance, meaning they are in different sections as we see, they are not in the same section, they are separated. So now he says, ekasya anuvadakattvam, viprakrishta pradesha, so they are in a well-known section, you see this. I'll confirm this with the mantra. When we see the mantra, if there is a number I can find. I have mentioned some numbers here. So anyway, prakrishta. So we can say that, so there is a prasiddha section. So in the prasiddha section, viprakrishta pradeshastha. So they are not separated. We can see in the same section. So in the same shakha, eka shakha, yeah, and in a well-known section, viprakrishta, what do we see? We see some mantras there as to what the two particular vidhis are seen. So, just let me rethink. Let me just ihatu ekashakaya viprakrishta pradeshastha vakyo. So viprakrishta can be seen as this prakrishta, as prasiddha also, but viprakrishta meaning it's a well known section, that's why he's being, we can see that he is bringing up an example. But then viprakrishta can also mean separated out. So we can see that in the single shakha, if it is in the same section, then anyway it will come together. It is in the same section. So you'll use some linga and say, oh, this is a linga. Prakarana is a linga. So you'll say if the Shruti is not matching, so Shruti, linga, ityadi pramanas are there. So some pramana has to be seen. So linga can be a pramana, Shruti can be a pramana. If they are missing, prakarana can be, same prakaranastha can be a pramana, and thereby you can bring them into a single vidhi. Now what the Purvapakshi is saying, that these viprakrishta pradeshastha vakyo, meaning they are separated. We can say with the in different sections. So whether it is a large or a small distance, they are different sections. So actually it means great distance, but we'll see in the single shakha, there are two different sections in which two different things are occurring. Whether they are same or not, that is a question now. So ihatu eka shakhayam viprakrishta pradeshastha vakyayo ho. So two vakyas, whether they have eka vakyata or not, ekasya anuvadakattvam anyasya vidhayakattvam iti anishchayad. So Purvapakshi is saying that now you cannot ascertain whether they should be clubbed together or not. Meaning the gunas discussed in two sections, two vakyas which are separated. They are not together. So when they are not together, across shakhas, when they are not together, definitely they are not together across shakhas, but there is a same vidya, and thereby you analyze and brought them together. In the earlier section, you separated out by saying that one is an anuvada and other is a vidhi. So you cannot club them together, they become two different vidyas. So one prana vidya during bhojana is different from the prana vidya elsewhere. Some prana vidyas are clubbed together, but this bhojana, antargata prana vidya, should not be clubbed together with the others. This is how you have done the analysis. Now similarly, in a single shakha, when you have two vakyas which are having two different vidhis, whether they should be clubbed together or not, there is nothing to tell you. One is anuvadaka and the other is what, anyasya vidhayaka. So one is an anuvada, another is a vidhi. That kind of a nirnaya cannot be made. Therefore what, anishyad ubhayurapi swanikatastha guna vishishta vidya vidhayakatvam iti pratyudharana sangatya idamaham. Now he is saying that therefore, like earlier, you cannot have this. It's a counter example. Earlier you could say one is an anuvada and the other is prasiddha is an anuvada and aprasiddha apurva is a vidhi. Therefore you separated it out. मीनिंग वाक्य भेद वॉज अवॉइडेड एंड सिंगल विधि वॉज टेकन विच इज अनग्नता चिंतन, प्राण से अनग्नता चिंतन. नाउ हियर काउंटर एग्जाम्पल इज दैट नाउ हियर यू डू नॉट हैव टू से, यू हैव नथिंग टू कंक्लूड एज टू विच पार्ट आउट ऑफ दीज टू. वन वाक्य हैज अनुवादकत्व एंड द अदर वाक्य हैज विधेयत्व. वन इज ऑर्डेंट, द अदर इज जस्ट अ रीस्टेटमेंट. दिस काइंड ऑफ एनालिसिस कैन नॉट बी डन. देयर फोर वॉट शुड यू डू, बोथ ऑफ दीज आर वॉट दे आर शुड बी सीन विथ विच एवर गुणाज आर डिस्कस देयर, दोज गुणाज शुड बी सीन दे इन द सेम शाखा ऑल्सो, यू कैनॉट क्लब देम टूगेदर. देयर फोर स्वनिकटस्थ गुण विशिष्ट विद्या, दैट विद्या विच इज अलॉन्ग विद द गुणाज विच आर नियर, गुणाज विच आर स्वनिकट मीनिंग नियर टू इट सेल्फ, सो दे आर सेपरेटेड बाय सम डिस्टेंस एंड द गुणाज डिस्कस्ड इन वन वाक्य एंड द गुणाज डिस्कस्ड इन अदर वाक्य शुड नॉट बी क्लब टूगेदर, दे शुड बी सीन एज टू डिफरेंट विद्या. देयर फोर दैट विद्या विधायकत्व, द विद्या उपासना इज ऑर्डेन्ड इन टू डिफरेंट सेक्शंस विद दोज पर्टिकुलर गुणाज विच फाइंड देमसेल्व्स इन द नियर विसिनिटी ऑफ दैट वाक्य. इति प्रत्युदाहरण संगत्या इदमः, एंड देयर वाय समानाधिकरणम कम्स अप एज टू अ काउंटर एग्जाम्पल गिवन बाय द पूर्वपक्षी. एंड व्हाट डज ही से, ही सेज समानम, नॉट ही से, भगवान सूत्रकार से समान एवं चाभेदात, समान एवं चाभेदात, समान एवं चाभेदात, समाने, समान है समाने, एकार हैज गॉन अवे, समाने एवं च अभेदात. सो समाने, समाने मीन्स समान शाखायाम, इन दी सेम शाखा, इन द सिंगल शाखा एवं, एवं मीन्स व्हाट, एवं एका एव विद्या, इन दी से दिस क्लबिंग टुगेदर, गुण उपसंहार शुड बी डन, वाई अभेदात, हेतु इज अभेदात, बिकॉज ऑफ अभेदा, अभेद ऑफ व्हाट, इवन इफ दे आर सेपरेटेड इन द सेम शाखा, इफ द सिमिलर विद्या इज सेपरेटेड ऑल्सो, विप्रकृष्ट ऑल्सो, स्टिल दे शुड बी क्लब टुगेदर बिकॉज देर इज अभेद इन द विद्या, दे आर दिस सेम विद्या. देयर फोर एकाएव विद्या, एवं मीन्स एकाएव विद्या वन, एंड सेकेंड वॉट गुण उपसंहारश्च यथा भिन्न शाखस्तयो. सो एवं मीन्स वॉट, द वे वी हैव डन एनालिसिस एंड क्लब टुगेदर गुणास फ्रॉम डिफरेंट शाखाज लुकिंग एट मेनी फैक्टर्स एंड कंक्लूड दैट इज अ सिंगल विद्या, देयर फोर गुण उपसंहार शुड बी डन, दैट एनालिसिस शुड बी डन दी एक शाखा ऑल्सो, समाने अपि, समाने अपि मीन्स इन दी समान शाखा ऑल्सो. सो दैट इज सूत्रार्थ. भगवान सदाशिव ब्रह्मेन्द्र सेज इन दी वृत्ति, अत्र पूर्वपक्षे विद्ययोः भेदाद् गुण अनुपसंहार, विसिद्धान्ते विद्यैक्याद् गुण उपसंहार इति फलभेद. वी हैव डन इट मेनी टाइम्स. सो व्हाट इज द पूर्वपक्ष, ही सेज दी गुणा शुड नॉट बी क्लब टुगेदर. सिद्धांती सेज इट इज अ सिंगल विद्या, गुणा शुड बी क्लब टुगेदर इन दी सिंगल शाखा. वाजसनीय शाखायां अग्निरहस्य शांडिल्य विद्या श्रूयते. सो वाजसनीय शाखा इज वेर बृहद ऑकर. सो समटाइम्स व्हाट आई से इज बृहद शाखा. सो वाजसनीय शाखायां अग्निरहस्य शांडिल्य विद्या श्रूयते. इन द सेक्शन अग्निरहस्य, अग्निरहस्य इज दैट सेक्शन वेर उपनिषद हैज नॉट बिगन येट, इट इज प्रायर टू द उपनिषद, दैट इज अग्निरहस्य. रहस्य इज ऑल्सो विद्या, इट इज एन उपासना. एंड शांडिल्य विद्या इज अनदर उपासना. सो देर इज अ विद्या श्रूयते. सो नाउ दिस अग्निरहस्य, इन दि अग्निरहस्य सेक्शन देर इज अ शांडिल्य विद्या उपासना. इन दि प्रायर टू उपनिषद सेक्शन देर इज सम उपासना विच वी हियर श्रूयते. वॉट इज दैट, स आत्मान उपासीत मनोमयम प्राण शरीरम भारूपम इत्यादिना. सो वॉट डू यू हियर, वी सी आत्मान उपासीत, वन शुड डू आत्म उपासना. इन विच मैनर, मनोमय प्राण शरीर भारू, प्राण शरीर प्राणमय, भारूप इज एफिलजेंट एक्सेट्रा. सो इत्यादिना, दिस इज हाउ दी उपासना इज ऑर्डेन्ड. तत्रैव बृहदारण्यके पुनः सैव श्रूयते. सो इन दि सेम शाखा, वाजसनीय शाखा, तत्रैव मीनिंग, एंड देन उपनिषद कम्स अप. सो दैट इज बृहदारण्यक. सो बृहदारण्यके पुनः सैव श्रूयते, सा एव विद्या श्रूयते. वॉट इज दैट विद्या, मनोमयम अयम पुरुषो भास सत्यः इति. सो इन द फिफ्थ चैप्टर यू हियर ऑफ बृहदारण्यक इन अग्नि रहस्य शांडिल्य विद्या व्हाट इज हर्ड सिमिलर थिंग इज हर्ड इन मनोमय अयम पुरुषः भाः सत्यः इति सो तत्र किम अग्नि रहस्य बृहदारण्यकस्तयोः विद्ययोः भेदः उत ऐक्यमिति विषये व्हेन देयर इज अ डाउट एज टू वेदर दी उपासना इन द शांडिल्य विद्या इन दी अग्नि रहस्य एंड दी सिमिलर विद्या टॉट इन व्हाट इन बृहदारण्यक उपनिषद सेक्शन इज देयर डिफरेंस और नॉट और आर दे सेम अनयोः विद्ययोः भेद इति पूर्वपक्ष पूर्वपक्ष इज सेइंग दैट देयर इज भेद सो वन इज ऑकरिंग इन अग्नि रहस्य विच इज आउटसाइड ऑफ उपनिषद प्रॉपर एंड उपनिषद हैज दिस उपासना सो देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ डिस्टेंस ऑल्सो सो दैट इज अ विप्रकृष्टत्व देयर इज अ प्रसिद्ध सेपरेशन ऑल्सो सिद्धांतस्तु हाउएवर सिद्धांत इज वॉट यथा भिन्नासु शाकासु विद्यैक्यं गुणोपासो महारश्च भवति एवं समाने च समानायाम् अपि शाखायाम् भवितुं युक्तम् सो सिद्धांत इज द वे वी हैव क्लब टुगेदर गुणास फ्रॉम उपासनास अक्रॉस डिफरेंट शाखा सिमिलरली इन द सेम शाखा ऑल्सो इन डिफरेंट सेक्शंस इफ देर इज उपासना which can be seen as a single upasana, guna upasamahara should be done. You should club together as a single upasana. Kutaha. Why? Abhedat. Because of there being no difference between the two vidyas taught here in this example. Upasyasya manomayatvadi gunakasya ubhayatrapi abhedana pratyabhijnanat. When you are doing atma upasana in Shandilya Vidya of Agni Rasya, there you have to see this atma as one that has taken manas with tadatmya sambandha and has become mana as though manomaya is actually a sharira is a kosha but atma has tadatmya sambandha therefore this is how one should do upasana where I see this manas there itself atma is there paramatma is there I am there and manas is not really chaitanya but this is how the upasana is and prana sharira prana is also prana is not separate from me it has existence due to me That will be taught in the Brihat. So, Manomaya Ityadi also is taught in the Brihat Upasana. Purusha is Paramatma, Atma, Brahmatma, and that is Manomaya. Then Prana Sharira elsewhere in the Shandilya Vidya, and then Bha Rupam and Bhaha are same. But Satya is different and Prana Sharira is different. This Prana Sharira kind of Upasana is taught in Shandilya Vidya, Agni Rasya, and then this Satya is taught in Brihat. Therefore, this guna upasamhara should be done or not. Purvapakshi said it should not be done. And Siddhanti is saying when you are looking at manomayam and manomayaha, there manomayam in napunsaka and manomayaha, not napunsaka, atmanu upasita. So as karma to upasita, manomaya, atma should be seen as manomaya. And here the statement as to manomayaha, ayam purusha, this purusha is manomaya. So when you hear that manomaya, if you have studied the shakha, then there will be pratyabhijna as to, oh, this manomaya I have seen there also. That atma I have seen as manomaya there also in upasana. If you have done the upasana, then shandilya vidya comes to mind. And then you see that this purusha who is atma is seen as manomaya there also and here also. Therefore, it is a single vidya because of pratyabhijna, pratyabhijnanam. So abheda, therefore there is abheda, upasyasya manomayatvadi gunakasya, that atma in Shandilya Vidya is same as this purusha here, why? Because manomayatvadi gunas are heard there also and here also, ubhayatra api abhedena pratyabhijnanat, one gets this pratyabhijna, evancha agni rahasye vidyam vidhaya brihadaranyake tadanuvadena sarva ishanatvadayaha gunaha vidiyante, then what is done, some other gunas are also taught. They may be different from what is taught earlier. So, Agni Rahasya Vidyam Vidaya, having taught this Upasana in Shandilya Vidya in Agni Rahasya before Upanishad, in Upanishad section, Brihadaranyaka, what is taught, Brihadaranyake, Tad Anuvadena, this Manomaya Ityadi, which was already seen as Atma, Upasana, Gunas, those are brought back here and thereby there is Anuvada. You already heard this in the earlier section. Now, when the Shruti is saying, it brings to mind what has already been said, meaning it is already prasiddha for you. So now it is not a vidhi. that manomayatva is not really a vidhi here, it is an anuvada. So we can say just like earlier, this achamana was anuvada and prana anagnata was anagnata chinta was vidheya. Similarly here you can say manomayatvadi gunas which you already heard, they are anuvada and now brahadaranyake tadanuvadena, this agni rasya, whatever gunas are talked, they are repeated here and then new things are ordained. Sarvesha, sarva isha, ishana, ishana is ishvara. So ishvaratvam meaning ishanatvam meaning ruling over everyone. Ishvara gunas are also taught. Those are vidhi, the new gunas, ishvaratva, that purusha is paramatma ishvara, this atma is parameshvara, that kind of a vidhi can be seen anew. Iti ubhayatra shandilya vidya ikyam iti siddham. So shandilya vidya in agni rasya and shandilya vidya itself in brahadaranyaka are one and the same upasana. If you want similarity with earlier, you are showing a counter example, it won't work because which gunas you already know in shandilya vidya, they are repeated here, that it is only an anuvada. And then with pratyabhijna, you know this as a single upasana. What is done is that what is not known, they are add-on gunas. Thereby it is a single vidya, chandilya vidya. Thereby the samana adhikaranam is over. We look at the new adhikaran in the next patha. Amnayantika samsiddham adhi madhyanta varjitam anandaghanam apurnam atmit jyotir upasmahi. Namaste, dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada, Sanjeev.